Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year to all our cherished viewers. You're welcome back to the One Media GH channel. Today, we bring to you a recap on an exciting trip we took to Jarapa, Dubai in the Upper West region of Ghana. The purpose of our trip was to explore the famous Royal Kosi Hills Hotel, popularly known as the Jarapa Dubai, in the Upper West region. At the entrance of the hotel is a very tight security checkpoint. Here, our car was checked before we were allowed entry to the main hotel premises. At the front of the premises is a very large space area for vehicle parking. To the right of the reception is a clothing shop. And to the left is a restaurant. And on the other hand, there is the very large swimming pool area where people have games and all sort of activities. We did all necessary requirements and decided to take some footages of the rooms at the premises. Murata is the person who guided us on this part. Just have a gaze at this beautiful environment. Now I guess you know why I call this place a full community. Different accommodations are available, ranging from standard to executive rooms. Everything that you ever expect to make your holidays great is found here. These peacocks you see around here are the commonest animals you find here. They just make the place much brighter.
Dubai, what are some of the experiences I will buy a Unyaya when you bet me a share? Because I've any years here, bedroom, maybe we learn from you.
Okay, me banra.
Okay.
And I'm a farm 1 week package. It's almost a lot of programs outlined. And then I'll pay your call safari, the moon lions, the moon people, the other sort of wildlife. Everyone was saying, being local, cry, we go over to go for 2 points, a cooking, a coffee. The community is not so out there. The BB saying, okay, sir, tourist board, they tell me the bomb on the road, my and go for.
And see, okay, to buy so far, what's me ash and who near my and I say, as days goes on, no, and the rest
of the world. And I'm coffee.
Oh, okay, yeah. Okay.
Tell me about rain. Okay.
The Maya and then the Maya okay. And you said that, you know, then you over relaxing, what has an ocean environment in your idea. How do you see it? When you saw, and I say, you see, sir, near my view of where I was in Commodore Fra near the.
Oh, when you saw a town ride, and I'm in one of. Workers, I'm making sure say town ride. Tourists pass and I and they have money to spend.
Okay.
But I'm making sure say town ride. Omni local community.
Okay.
For anything a tourist waiting me at all. I'm no more arranging. So we are more town ride now. No more after her.
Okay.
And I so much I spend it to increase the local economy.
Okay.
It shouldn't be just if you are coming in a whole world, but there's so much community so in your
okay. That is your better say, and come on, I had the pan, but you Uber who said, yes, you're a rider,
but
it's what you're wedding can with taste of it. It's your friend, yes, you're a quack or shed, and yes, you're a cobard, you're a wakan, yes, you're better to fight to it. Yeah, that was a say, and we do.
The tour guide here took us through a series of orientations before we started our safari.
My name is Prosper Jago. I'm a tour guide of the facility. I might lead some of you on your tour. I don't know which you do. But before we get to the safari, there are some things that I would like to bring to our knowledge. First of all our animals in the safari, none of them is tame. They were all brought in from their natural environment. They are not tame. So we don't advise that you try to pet any animal, no matter how friendly they might be. Unless the tour guide asks you to touch an animal, don't try to touch it. And some of our fences are electrified. But the tour guide will tell you which one is and which one is not, so that we are careful.
This is the safari, yes.
Okay. So, the Ababedru. Kadi can dey atu and you say baby are you from there's place different places. I had the Ababedru. Enti no. So we show you here the airport we ha no so say definitely am ofra na say you kura no me kura me na me try say me say ride the bike ni beni ade. Enti ya be din komo, ya be kwani enso ride beni ade. But tour guide na nkasa wa ha say yenene ni komo. Ye mi say say so far expectation be and what he expected, it was a safari, I say. So, me more about the bad word media change.
Thank you. Okay, first of all, I'll thank you so much for coming around. But I will promise you excitement to the highest degree, because it is only in this safari that you get to see some of the animals closely and then plainly without any covering whatsoever. Okay, Over here we have our hippo pond. You are expected to see hippopotamus. We have hippopotamus. We have alpacas. We have our giant tortoises. We have mares also here. Then further on we have ostriches. Then we have lions, civet cats, baboons. Then in the free range we also have zebras and about 5 species of antelopes. Yeah. For the free range animals, I cannot guarantee that we'll see them because they are always on the move, you understand? But with the confined animals, they are in a confinement, so they don't have anywhere to go. But with the free range animals, they are always moving. So if you look for them and you don't see them, then that would be a loss. But you would have seen other animals as well. Okay, to be on the safer side, you know, it's a safari and you might enter bush and maybe you'll be riding a quad bike. So if you are a lady, I would advise you are in your trousers just like you are, and you are in your sneakers. This is the best dressing for a safari. So just dress in your trousers so that walking will be easy for you. And don't wear high heels in the safari. You can wear sneakers or boots like mine. That way you'll be prepared.
Thank you very prepared. Much. And I'm sure we are going to enjoy our trip.
Exactly.
What is your name?
Prosper Jato.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Quad bikes you see around here are possibly for the tourists. And the guards will actually take you through a 2-minute orientation on how to ride this bike before we embark on a journey.
Pinching yourself like this. But the part of the body that you are supposed to be mindful of is the legs. There's power, so much power in the leg. And it has the ability to kick you in front and also at the back. And each kick is deadly. It can injure you with the kick. And that's how they... And that's how they protect themselves. That is defensive mechanism. We've been told that a kick on the head of a lion can break the skull open because there's power in the legs. And they are edible.
Yes, you need to remove the skin as well. And because the skin is as tough as that of a cow. So without you removing the skin, the meat might not get cooked in time. It will take a long time for it to get cooked. Okay, any questions? The skin of the beak. The beak is not the problem. The problem is the leg. The beak is almost like plastic. Though it might be painful to some people who have very soft palms. But some of us would say half.
So age-wise, how many years can they take?
From 14 to 40 years. They can live from 14 to 40, depending on the species. That's our last one. These ones can live up to 40 years.
40 years. Mm. 3 days before?
They lay eggs.
Uh-huh.
So once they lay eggs, either 28 days or 30 days before the eggs will hatch.
Okay.
They sit on it. And that's how they are. But there's food. They like poking on things. They like And that's the reason why we don't allow them to go hungry. Always there's food in their trough. You see, this
so what do they eat?
They eat like fowls, grains, seeds. We give them crushed maize mixed with rice bran, sometimes mixed with wheat bran,
okay,
for them to eat.
Can I feel the pellet?
Okay. You want to feel it or you want to have one?
Feel it.
Okay, feel it. Try. Like this. Then this way. You can come this way. This one will be perfect.
So I mean they are not
right here.
They can be pets.
Yes. Especially when they are laying. They are very, very aggressive when they start laying. Very aggressive towards humans. When they
so
start
can
laying.
They break this though?
They
can't.
They can't open it.
They can't
open it. It's secured here.
Okay.
What if they eat
garlic? I bet they cannot. If not by now, they would have been out. Have you seen here? You see, one of the a part of it is protruded like it. It's one of the males was chasing the other. This one was chasing this one. So if they went all the way here, this one came and took a sharp turn. Your man came and hit and went and fell down. But they cannot escape. Lions then, or let's say lions confirming. This is the male, obviously. This is the one they have used to make that nursery rhyme. A lion has a tail, it has a big head and very small. But this one doesn't have a small wrist too. The wrist is too big.
That's right.
I'm trying for it to come to the,
oh, okay,
to the fence. But usually, lions are this calm. People think that they go about killing humans and other animals haphazardly. No. The lions will only attack for two reasons. One, when it is hungry to feed. Secondly, when it sees danger or when you are a threat or a danger to it, it's coming. And sometimes when you are vulnerable, like as I'm talking to you and with my back turned to them, it can just try to come on me. That's how they behave, and that is how they hunt. Okay, and they are strictly carnivorous, only meat, Wednesdays, Fridays, and each male is a full cow, a big cow.
You know, that you mean that's how you chose to feed them, or if they get low, eat.
Check them. How do they look? Do they look malnourished?
Yeah, they look pretty
good. So the feeding is good for them, actually. In the wild, lions can live over 2 weeks without eating.
Hello.
They know how to, manage hunger.
You are so beautiful.
Yes. It will reach. We kill. Is the cow is big? It's huge. Big cow, not small one. So that we divide it into four. And how we feed them? Let's move this way. Because I know somebody will ask me, how do we feed them? So when we kill the cow and we bring it, they are also used to the routine. We use the tricycle to feed them. So the moment we cut the cow into pieces and we are coming, then they hear the sound of the tricycle and perceive the scent of the meat.
Still in there. You go.
There's
to
a door inside. That's the only door entering into the den. So but when we come, for us to open the door, you pull on this pulley system. If you come this way, you appreciate it. If you look through this window, you see your door over there. So now, let's take it down to the feeding bay. We have come with the meat. And we have packed here. Now I come to pull here and lock it so that it stays open.
Okay.
Then they themselves will enter. Okay. If they are not entering, we use piece of meat to lure them to enter. Once we are sure that the four of them are all inside, then we release this, locking them inside here. And from here, we can move them to the next compartment, to the next, and then to the other side of the fence. But as they are here, we can now open this door, enter, pick up their feces and leftover meat, come out, we bag it, put it down, then now send the pieces of meat in, put them at various points. Now when we are out and this door is securely locked, we open it again, release them to go out for their food. Okay, that's how we feed them. But in fact, we have water tanks inside and also inside the den, in the yard and also inside here. And the ones in the yard has it's a system. Once the water is dirty in the tank, we open the outlet so the water flows, the dirty water flows out, then we pump fresh water in to the tank. Okay, so always there's water for them to drink. The stone structure and those locks inside, we are trying as much as possible to make the place look as natural as their natural environment. You know, in the wild, they like living in higher pedestrian, rocky areas or mountain areas, sometimes in caves. So we are trying to make it look like that for them. In fact, the lion, the male lion is highly polygamous. It likes a lot of women. But these three are not enough for him. In the wild, one male lion can have over 13 females as wives. But you can never see two males in the same group. They always fight, and their fight is always to the death. Unless the weaker one surrenders and runs away from the territory. Man, I'm even better than you. The lion cannot mate over 1 minute. Highest is 1 minute. Usually it's 30 seconds and it's done. Okay, let's see. Let me try to let it come close.
Okay.
Because now they are used to all the tricks we use on them to come to the net. But today I tried one and it worked. Let me see if it will work for you people. So get your cameras ready.
It's coming.
Get your cameras ready. Is it coming?
Yeah,
it's coming. So I'll run past and it will chase. So get your cameras ready. Did you capture it? It will come
again. Yes.
Yes.
Is it
coming?
No.
Oh,
he's mine now.
It will not come again. Okay, let me try to climb again.
Hold on.
That's how they are. If it knows you don't pose a threat to it, it will disturb itself. So, you see, when there is commotion, the females are lying unconcerned. That is the duty of the man, to protect their family and also to mate for procreation. The females are the ones that do the hunting. In the wild, they hunt because of their slenderness, and people think that they are the most dangerous, but the power is with the male. But he's not always completely exempted from the hunting. resist a distance of the hunting scene. In case the females are unable to overcome the animal, he comes in to help. If not, the females, as they are duty to hunt, catch the animal, kill it, but the male will be the first to eat, whether he's part of the hunting or not. And when he comes, either he lies down to eat to its food and move away, or he'll come and tear off his portion, move away and eat, and then actually this is not the electricity, electrification is not affecting this. It's rather the cables, inner cables. These ones are insulated, so current cannot pass through. It's the inner cables. Yes. If you see, it will dare not touch the fence. When it was chasing me, it will never touch it. In some cases, when it is extremely annoyed, it will try to touch it. But when the moment it touches it, you see that it will move forward, backwards, and lie down because of the shock. They've all had their fair share of the electrical shock, so they are aware of the fence. Are you all good?
Yes.
No question, right? Okay, then. What happened? So, from on the Kumasi Accra Road, boys have been holding some animal. The accounts call it Kankani. Mm-hmm. This is Kankani.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. That's what they've been selling along the roadside. So, the English name is civet cat. And one thing about them is that they don't defecate anyhow. They locate a particular portion where everybody goes to do it. So this is where they defecate. And if any of them should make a mistake and defecate anywhere else aside the designated place, the rest will come together and punish it.
Yes.
By clawing it and biting it. If you look at this one, you see the face. It means it offended and they punished him. Yes. And this is a good act, but it happens to be their doom in the forest. Because those who hunt them, once they spot their feces, they know that they are around, and they know that wherever they go to eat, they surely come back there to defecate. So either they set traps, or they lay ambush. When they come back, they catch them. Okay? So that's the civet cat for us. And then this other fence contains the jackal. This one. Look at it. And for the jackals, they are equally omnivorous animals. But they are of the dog family. Can you see it? Jackal. J-A-C-K-A-L. Yes. Come over here. It will be pacing around because it doesn't trust we human beings. The rest are hiding. They burrow holes into the ground under the rocks, and they'll be hiding there. You know, they are nocturnal. In the daytime, they like to hide away and rest. In the night, then they now are active to me. Well, when they are in a pack of 10, 15, 20, they are harmful. But when they are about 4 or 5, they are so scared of humans and any other thing. Oh, we enter there, they run away. They just be moving away. Jackal. In the wild, they move in packs.
Do you have hyenas here?
Not yet. In fact, we don't want to have hyenas. They are very bad animals. I don't like them. I don't like hyenas. So, you can touch the fence. It's not electrified. In the wild, they move in packs. And in a pack of 15 to 20, they can kill a lion. They can kill a buffalo. In fact, any animal at all they set out to kill, they can kill it. Yes, so they are dangerous when they are in their pack. Yes, they attack in groups. This one will batten, each one will batten a part of the prey. So by so doing, they overwhelm it and kill it. So when the lion, if it is alone and it sees a pack of jackals, it will move away. Fast. If not, they can hurt it. Okay, so from here, our next stop will be at our baboon's cage. And please, when we get there, don't go too close to the cage. Because baboons are very smart and very fast. They can snatch anything from you within the twinkle of an eye. watch the ape movie, that big monkey movie. So it was brought here as at the time the movie was trending. King Kong, the ape, that big monkey movie. Okay, I love it, yes. Beautiful lady. Yes, that's a baboon. This one is a female baboon. Ask a question there.
Which one is it?
It's not disease, it's not a sickness. So. Not only it is undergoing menstruation. So when it's undergoing the menstrual cycle, the vulva actually is the one that has gotten so swollen like that.
Jesus.
Okay. So every month it undergoes this. So once a female baboon attains the puberty age, it can never have a flat buttocks like the male one. Okay. So the male one is called Kiki. Kiki. And Kiki, oh, he has already erected because he has seen beautiful.
Hey!
Oh, I'm not lying. Look at the penis. See, before, you see, he's giving you eyes. You see, look at the eyes. You look at the eyes. He's giving, you see? Yeah, yeah. He's giving you eyes. He's inviting you. And the female is called Magdalene.
Magdalene
behind the name. Just like you could put them. There's a time some tourists came here, and then, even though we told them not to get so close to the cave, there was a lady among them who was called Magdalene. She said baboons are her favorite animals. So when we got it, she was so excited. She refused to listen to us. Then she was like, hey, then Kiki put out the hand and put on her head. Fortunately or unfortunately for her, she was wearing a wig, not a weaver. If it was a weaver, then it would have been a different case. So Kiki managed to remove the wig. He looks at the wig, look at the woman, and went to also place the wig on his wife. So everybody was laughing. The woman's friends were even making fun of her that the baboon wearing the wig is looking like her. So, so that's how come she got her name. So they started calling her Magdalene, and the name has stayed with her until now. But of course, we couldn't retrieve the
Madeline again.
The wig.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it was a wig. That's what I don't know. Anytime she sees, I don't know what she's looking for. Whether she's looking for hair or she's wondering why I'm not having hair like her. We fed them for 3 months. That was our probational period when we were working here. We started working here first. So baboons are such a way that when you feed them, they get used to you. Even if you travel several years and you come, they'll still recognize you. So I used to feed her a lot. And my colleague used to feed this. I didn't like Kiki. He has taken my face towel several twice and my sheets twice. So each time I'm here, I'm holding my sheets.
What do they eat?
They eat fruits and vegetables. And legumes.
So how do you give
it? Pass it through here, then they'll collect it. If you had a biscuit right now, who has biscuit? You can feed it. Right, you pass it through. They can, you see, you just pass it. If we open this door, they'll come out. Actually, they were left roaming freely. This is just a temporary confinement for them. They were left roaming freely, but they used to climb outside, go into the community and cause trouble, and come inside here innocently, like they've done nothing. But the committee members used to complain, and the company was paying for damages every now and then. So we had to put them here whilst we are working on their permanent dwelling place close to our office over there. Once it's complete, we are going to electrify it too so that we can't climb out again. So this is just temporary for them. So very soon we'll be going out. Any questions on baboons? Are you okay? Okay, now off to the lake. Laura! Yeah, Laura!
So, cherished viewers, that's all we have for you today. And make sure to subscribe to our channel so that you keep witnessing our exciting trips and journeys. Don't forget to share this video to your friends so that they could all enjoy this exciting trip. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year to you all.